Hello everyone, welcome to our channel SKM Tutorials Hub. In this series of lecture, I have been discussing about the C language, and in this video I will show you how to run a C program. I will be using VS Code, or rather Visual Studio Code, along with MinGW compiler. In this video I will show you the entire setup, and at the end I will show you how to run a C program in VS Code. So please watch the video till the end, and if you are new to this channel, then please consider subscribing to our channel and also press the bell icon for getting the latest updates. First of all, we will download Visual Studio Code or VS Code from its official website. I have also given the link in the description box. Now I am using 64-bit Windows, so I am downloading user installer accordingly. Now if you are using some other operating system, then please download the corresponding file. You can see that the download has already started at the bottom left corner. So this is our VS Code exe file. Now let's start the installation. Accept the agreement here, and then here you don't need to change anything, just click next. Here also just click next. Now here you check these two boxes, and if you want to create a desktop icon, then check this box also, then click next, and here now click the install button. So you can see that the installation has started. So now VS Code installation is complete. At this point of time, we are not going to launch the Visual Studio Code, because for running a C program, only VS Code is not enough. Along with it, we will also require a compiler. So now let's download the compiler for VS Code from the official website, that is visualstudio.com. I have given the link in the description box. Now in this page, you scroll down until you get the link for MinGW download. So the download will start automatically within 5 seconds. So you can see at the bottom left corner that the file has already been downloaded. So this is our MinGW installer file. Now let's start the installation. So here click the next button. If you are using 64-bit architecture, then select that from the drop down menu of architecture and then click next. Here no need to change anything, just click next. So you can see that the installation has started. In my case, it took almost 9 minutes for the installation to complete. So here click next, now finish. So the MinGW has already been installed now. Now our next step will be to set the path of our compiler. For this, open this PC, then right click on this PC, select properties, then open advanced system settings. There you get environment variables, click on that. Now you will get a dialog box showing different environment variables. Now under system variables, you will see the variable named path. Double click on it. So another dialog box opens up. Select new, as we are going to set a new path under this environment variable. So now browse your compiler. So remember, you have to select the entire path up to the bin folder of MinGW compiler. Once you are done, click OK in all the dialog boxes. So now we have set the path. Now let's check whether we have set the path of the compiler correctly or not. For that, open the command prompt, then give the command gcc -v. So this command must show the gcc compiler version. So you can see that when I give the command gcc -v, the gcc version 8.1.0 has been shown. So that means that our path has been correctly set. So our initial setup is complete now. Now let's try to run a C program in VS Code. For that, make a new folder wherever you want to store your C programs. Here I have made a new folder named C programs in D drive. Now open that folder in VS Code. So our Visual Studio Code or VS Code has opened now. This is the welcome page, you can close it. Now see, at the left hand side our new folder is being shown. Now let's add a new file within our folder. Let us name it hello.c. This is our first program. You can see, as soon as I created a new file with .c extension, VS Code has recommended to install some extensions for C. So let's click install. So the C++ extension has been installed. Now we can close this tab. Now in order to run a C program, we will need one more extension, that is CodeRunner. So let's install the CodeRunner extension also. The CodeRunner extension has been installed now. Now let's write our program. We will start with a very basic C program, that is printing hello world. You can see that while writing the program, VS Code is giving different suggestions. Also, when we start a curly brace, automatically the closing brace is given. So this is all due to the extension which we installed, that is CC++ extension. Now we have finished writing our program. Let's run our program. At the top right hand corner, this is the run button, click on it. So at the bottom, you can see that our output has been displayed. Our program has written hello world. I have shown you how to run a very basic C program in VS Code. Now we will try to run another program which will take some input from the user. So we will add again a new file to our folder. Let us name it prog1.c. Let's write our program. So our program will ask for a number from the user and then it will display that number on the screen. Thank you. We have completed writing our program. Now let's try to run it. Again, click the run button on the top right hand corner. At the bottom, you can see that no output has been displayed. Instead, it is in the running state. Now, in order to take input from the users, we have to make some changes in the settings. So, click the settings button at the bottom left corner and then again select settings. Now, in settings, select the extensions. Now, in the drop down menu of the extension, select run code configuration. Now, scroll down until you get the run in terminal. Check the empty box where we have been asked whether to run code in integrated terminal. Now the settings have been updated, so you can close this tab now. Let's go back to our program now. Previously, our program was in the running state, so we will reopen our program in VS Code. Now click the run button and at the bottom you can see that the program is running and the program is asking for a number from the user. Let's give a number 10. So you can see that the number we have given has been displayed. So after changing the settings, our program has run successfully and has also given the correct output. In this video, I have shown the entire setup of VS Code along with the C compiler. I have also shown how to run different types of programs in VS Code. Hope you like the video. Thank you.